Nearly 1 in 5 of us women struggle to go to the bathroom regularly. It's one of the most common digestive issues. Bloating, discomfort, constipation. Yet obviously it's a little uncomfortable to talk about. But I didn't have trouble going. In fact, I had the opposite problem. My digestion was erratic, fast, and unpredictable. But I lived in Bali, I traveled to Uganda, Rwanda, Brazil for work, and I guess I kind of just assumed I had Bali belly or stomach issues from these travels. But honestly, it stressed me out a lot every time I ate, wondering how my stomach was going to handle it. I did blood and stool tests, but nothing showed up, except my low iron, which was kind of strange considering I eat a lot of red meat. But then my doctor mentioned SIBO, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. I'd never heard of it, and I was like, wait, is this something you get from traveling? But SIBO is not exotic. Actually, it's surprisingly common, especially in women, and it often flies under the radar.
SIBO is when bacteria that are supposed to stay in the large intestine end up in the small one, where they don't belong. Once they're there, they start fermenting your food too early in the digestive process, which creates gas, inflammation, and symptoms that show up in different ways. This might include fatigue, food sensitivities, skin issues, brain fog, and unpredictable digestion.
You can develop SIBO for a lot of reasons. It can be triggered by food poisoning or a slowdown in the gut's movement, coming from stress, travel, antibiotics, low stomach acid, or even hormonal changes. Basically anything that affects your gut's balance or weakens digestion. So how do we test for it?
The breath test for SIBO is pretty simple. First, you follow a special diet for a day and then fast overnight. The next morning, you drink your sugar solution, usually glucose, and then over the next couple of hours, you breathe into small tubes at regular intervals. These samples are analyzed for hydrogen and methane gases, byproducts of bacterial fermentation. If those gases spike too early, it's a strong indicator that bacteria are overgrowing where they shouldn't be.
So you came back positive for hydrogen SIBO, which is one of the two types. This is actually a lucky result because methane is harder to treat. Okay. So this is a simpler one that we can treat with just one antibiotic or one antimicrobial. And this is the one that usually comes with more diarrhea manifestations.
When people come to you with gut health issues, is SIBO the first test that you do?
Yes, I very often request SIBO, especially if there's food intolerances, which is basically the perception that a certain food makes you have the symptoms, right? Because very often these intolerances are not real intolerances, or they are, but they are transient. They are due to the SIBO. Because these bacteria are fermenting that specific food a lot.
Thankfully, when it came to treatment, I had options.
Rifaximin should be taken 3 times daily after a meal, so it doesn't have to be exactly every 8 hours. It should be breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
It won't kill my microbiome.
It will pass through your gut and act on your gut, and the way we prevent it from killing too many things is the probiotic as well.
So low FODMAP is something I should try and maintain for a few months at least?
Yes, definitely for the duration of the treatment.
Gotcha.
Which even if you go the antibiotic route, which is only 2 weeks max, we will do a probiotic with it for a bit longer, 3 to 4 weeks. Okay. And so I would advise to do the low FODMAP all throughout that treatment. Okay. And perhaps a week more, so like a month. Mm-hmm. With the herbals, it's the whole treatment, 6 weeks.
And can I drink alcohol?
Right, so you shouldn't.
I shouldn't?
You shouldn't. If you want to have like a glass of wine, glass of wine separated from the antibiotics and stuff, I mean, I don't think it would kill you.
Yeah.
But if you really want to make sure that we are like religious with the treatment, you shouldn't.
Oh, and the low iron, that made perfect sense too. Basically, it seems like that's the first thing us women should get tested.
SIBO can alter the acidity of your overall GI system, gastrointestinal system, and so it can affect the absorption of several different nutrients, mostly iron and B12, but sometimes also folic acid. In your case, considering your diet, I would say that it's more likely that it's caused by, or at least helped by SIBO than a natural deficiency.
I was talking with Lelda about the iron because she also had low iron.
Who doesn't?
Who doesn't?
I do, you do, she does.
And I was just shotting this little thing. Am I supposed to mix it with water?
No. You can shot it.
Okay.
Don't make a shot game out of it.
Let's be real. Half the time as women, we're not just managing our lives, we're also managing our digestion. Honestly, I was kind of relieved when I found out I had SIBO. It explained my bathroom anxiety, my roller coaster digestion, and now I had a problem that I could plan to solve. If you're experiencing gut issues, why not ask your doctor about SIBO? We deserve to feel good regularly and preferably in peace without a line forming outside the bathroom door. Hey, one last thing. If this was helpful and you want to see more videos about women's health and longevity, please hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Oh, and a quick reminder, this content is for informational purposes only and isn't medical advice.